Welcome to another edition of the CS Podcast, where you can hear interviews with special guests such as
Deon Buchanan, Tom Waddle, Pierre Desir, Dalis Thomas,
and many others.
Too big, too strong, too fast, too good.
So be sure to subscribe and tune into the CS Podcast on YouTube at youtube.com/ChristianRE722.
Did you not get the memo?
That's www.youtube.com/ChristianRE722 for great interviews. Be sure to check out the CS Podcast.
You are ridiculous.
Welcome back to the CS Podcast. I'm your host, Chris Shanafelt, and I am now joined by 2014 NFL draft prospect, cornerback out of Monmouth University, Tevrin Brandon. Thanks for joining the show, Tevrin. How's it going, man?
Thank you for having me. It's going really well.
Hey, man, the pleasure's all mine. So we're going to be talking about your football career, and I want to start this interview off by asking you a pretty simple question, and that is, I see you grew up in Pennsylvania, and in high school, you had a lot of success playing football and track. How did you decide to attend UConn? And, you know, I got to think they weren't the only college recruiting you, were they?
Yeah, they weren't. And I chose UConn for one reason. That was Randy Etzel at that time. He was a Pennsylvania guy. He recruited me. And I just liked everything he was about. I liked the way he shaped his program. He turned it around and took UConn to far places. Once he left, I mean, you could tell that the program wasn't the same without him, but that's one of the main reasons why I chose to go to the University of Connecticut.
I see you redshirted your first year at UConn in 2009. In 2010, you were able to play in 9 games. And in 2011, you played in all 12 games, both on defense and special teams for the UConn Huskies. And you were able to force and recover a fumble that season. Any chance you could tell us about that very first college football turnover that you forced and how it felt to get your offense back on the football field?
It was good. I mean, it was against an SEC school out there in Vanderbilt. And this is when they were just starting to get back on top and becoming a good team. And we needed a turnover at that game, and it was just really exciting. I popped up at the ball, and it was just exciting. And a good feeling to have being a younger player, being able to make an impact for his team.
Oh, I bet. Now, after playing a total 22 games with the UConn Huskies, you decided to transfer to Monmouth University. I'm curious, how did they win you over?
Monmouth?
Yeah.
Monmouth University, it was cool because I had come to visit prior to the spring game in the spring of 2012, and I just liked everything about it. Again, with Tobin as a coach and the environment, I mean, it was really similar to the environment that Randy Etzel created at UConn, where you have a coach who started a program and brought a program a long way in Kevin Callahan. And I was really intrigued with that. And also the distance to home was only about an hour and a half. And being on the beach is also a plus.
I see that you had to sit out your first year at Monmouth in 2012 to satisfy the NCAA residency restrictions. What were some things that you did during that time off to better your game?
I just participated as much as I could. You know, not being able to play and sit out, there's not much use for you besides being on the scout team, which I took full responsibility for that and jumped head first into that and helped the team out that way, helped the offense out by servicing them and just working hard in the weight room, getting my body right, and just not giving up and not being lazy was the main thing. And what had happened was during that time that I sat out, I got to prove to my teammates at Monmouth that they could trust me as a leader, and that's something I tried to do as well. And they voted me captain next spring after being here a couple months, which was the honor.
Mm-hmm. And I see, Tevrin, entering this past season, the 2013 season, it's your final year of your college football career, and it's your first year suiting up for the Hawks. I'm curious, how did you win the starting cornerback job? Was it something that you were promised when you made the transfer over from UConn, or was it that you impressed your coaches in practices and made them have no other choice but to start you? How did you get this starting job right away during your time at Monmouth?
Yeah, when I first came to the Monmouth, I competed in fall camp, and I still wasn't deemed ineligible yet. So I won the starting job my first year there. And then prior to the first game that season, NCAA called, and they said I couldn't play. So then that was a bummer. So spring camp came around, and I was still on top, and I kept fighting for the spot, and just overall, it was pretty much there when I got there, but I still had to earn it.
Tevrin, this past season for the Monmouth Hawks, you started all 12 games at cornerback and kick returner. You recorded 51 total tackles, 12 pass deflections, 3 interceptions, 2 block kicks, and a fumble recovery. I mean, that's one hell of a stat line, and if you turn on the film, we see that you are one hell of a player that makes a bunch of plays. And one that sticks out to me the most is that sick one-handed interception you had against Liberty. Now, that may or may not be the answer to this next question I have for you, but throughout your entire college football career, what has been the most memorable play that you've made?
That was probably the most memorable play. I mean, it was my first college interception, which was a plus, and just the way that it was done was just a great atmosphere and everything. And that game had its ups and downs, and probably not my best game in the season, but that helped our offense come back on the field and drive down
Chris Shanafelt talking with 2014 NFL Draft prospect, cornerback out of Monmouth University, Tevrin Brandon. Tevrin, I have a few more questions for you, then I'll let you go. I really do appreciate your time. And I see the other day that you had your pro day, and it was an impressive one. The number that sticks out the most is that 4.34 40-yard dash that you ran, which makes you the fastest defensive back entering the draft. Overall, how do you feel you performed at your pro day? I mean, are you satisfied with the numbers you put up?
Yeah, I'm satisfied with the numbers I put up. I mean, they were all great. 40 was great. My size for the bench, for all the stuff showed explosion. And yeah, that 40 really stuck out, and I was really happy with that. I knew I was going to run in the 4.3s, but I just had to prove that to the scouts that were there, because prior to the pro day, I was talking to one scout, and he said he's expecting me to run faster than everybody at the combine, which I made his prediction true.
Mm-hmm. How does that feel, having these, how does it feel to have these NFL scouts come up to you during your pro day after you have such a successful workout like you did?
It's rewarding. I mean, it's something that for the past 8 weeks, training day in and day out for 8 hours a day, you're putting all this hard work into it. You just want to see all that hard work be rewarded. And that was the first step of a reward, in hearing all the good signs from the scouts that I talked to, and just hearing that what they came to see, they seen, and they were really pleased with my performance overall, from testing-wise to positionals.
Getting ready for your pro day, and maybe even during your pro day, did you ever think, I'm going to make the NFL Combine regret not inviting me?
Yeah, I mean, at first, there was some chatter throughout whether I would get an invite or not, and some scouts telling me they think I deserve one, and I was really hoping on it, being in that last lead, but once I wasn't picked to be a part of the NFL Combine, I mean, I bit my tongue. I didn't really say much about it. I just, it didn't happen, and my pro day is the day I have to perform, so just being able to participate in a pro day and for the scouts was an honor.
Yeah, I bet, man, and you certainly impressed many with that 4.34 40 that, like we said, it certainly sticks out, and you definitely had an impressive day, what was it, just 2 days ago at your Monmouth University Pro Day. Tevrin, when did you find out that the NFL can not only be a dream, but it could become a reality?
Right after the season, you have the agents calling you in that whole process, but being invited to the Medal of Honor Bowl and talking to all 32 teams down there and discussing with the scouts my possible future, just that's when it all sunk in and became a true reality and a fact that's going to happen.
If you would compare yourself to a cornerback currently playing in the NFL today, who do you think that would be and why?
If I could compare myself, I would probably compare myself to someone like Brent Grimes down there in Miami. I mean, we got the same numbers, height and weight did. Mm-hmm. And compared to him.
Hey, can't go wrong with that. You just got a big payday over there in Miami with the Dolphins, so definitely one of the top cornerbacks in the NFL. My next question for you, Tevrin, is what is something about your game that you're most confident of, and what is something you feel that you could work on?
I'm most confident in, I love playing man-to-man, but I'm most confident in the speed, as you can tell. I mean, when I line up against somebody, I don't think they're going to run past me. I know nobody's going to run past me, so I'm not too worried about that. But something I need to work on personally is my eyes. At the next level, that could hurt me, but from the most part, it's improved throughout the season, and it's only going to get better.
Let's say there's an NFL general manager out there listening to this very interview. Why should he want Tevrin Brandon, cornerback out of Monmouth University, on his team?
If they want somebody who can rise up to the calling and in the face of adversity come out on top, it would be me. And if you want a tough player that's never going to give up, I'm that person. I'm going to play at a high level, at a high speed, with a high motor at all times, and do what I got to do to help my team win. And that's coming from being a special team guy. I mean, I play all special teams. I'm not one of those guys who's never had to play a special team and wouldn't want to. I mean, I'm living off special teams at UConn. And whether it's that or being a corner on the outside, corner on the inside, a package guy, whatever it is, I'm going to get the job done and help my team succeed.
I love it, man. Tevrin, thank you very much for your time, man. I really appreciate it. Congratulations on just a wonderful college football career, both at UConn and, of course, just this past season at Monmouth University. Congrats on a great pro day, man. I'm wishing you nothing but the best. Before I let you go, is there anything you'd like to say to myself and our listeners?
Thank you for having me. I really appreciate it. It was a good time.
Hey, we'll do it again in the future, man. Once again, I really appreciate it, and I'm wishing you nothing but the best. Take care, man.
Thanks for tuning into the CS Podcast. I hope you enjoyed. Please check out all of my past interviews at www.youtube.com/ChristianRE722. Once again, that's www.youtube.com/ChristianRE722. And be sure to follow me on Twitter @ChrisShanafelt.